Hello everyone, in this video tutorial I'm going to talk about probability and cumulative distribution functions using MATLAB. Now what is probability distribution function? It can be thought of as a function that provides probability of occurrences of different outcomes that can come in an experiment. I'm going to refer to probability distribution function as PDF. MATLAB provides us with two inbuilt functions that can be used to calculate PDF. One of them being exp PDF, which calculates the PDF on the basis of exponentially distributed data with respect to the mean of the data set. On the screen, you see the formula that can be used to calculate exponential PDF, wherein the lambda is the mean and x is the input data set. So let's try implementing the same thing using MATLAB. First, we'll initialize x that will go from 1 to 10. That will be our input data set. And suppose our lambda is 6. Now, lambda can be anything ranging from 0 to 10. So, in order to calculate exp exponential PDF using exp PDF, we'll have to pass both x and lambda as input arguments to this function. And in order to observe the output, I'll plot f against x. And that is a graph of exponential PDF using the inbuilt MATLAB functions. Moving on to normal PDF, the inbuilt function that is used to calculate normal or Gaussian PDF is normpdf, which will calculate the PDF for normally distributed data set with respect to the mean, the standard deviation of a data set. On the screen, you can see the formula that can be used to calculate normal PDF, wherein sigma is the standard deviation, lambda is the mean, and x is the input data set. So while calculating it using MATLAB inbuilt functions, I'm going to keep x and lambda the same. I'll initialize sigma and I'll pass all the three parameters as input. Let's plot the graph to observe. That is a normal PDF that is generated using the inbuilt MATLAB function. Moving on to cumulative distribution function, I'll refer to it as CDF. Now, CDF is a probability that the value of x for which the CDF is being calculated is either less than or equal to the value of x that is given as an input to the function. Similar to PDF, MATLAB has two inbuilt functions that can be used to calculate CDF, exp CDF and normal CDF. On the screen, you can see the formula that can be used to calculate exponential CDF, wherein all the parameters are same as explained before. So we'll just try to implement the same using MATLAB functions. The MATLAB functions that is used to calculate exponential CDF is exp CDF, for which we'll have to pass x and lambda as input parameters, and we'll observe the output using plot. That is the output of exponentially distributed CDF using inbuilt MATLAB functions. Moving on to normally distributed CDF, the function that is used to calculate normally distributed CDF is norm CDF, and for this CDF, similar to norm PDF, we'll have to pass x, lambda, and sigma as input parameters. And to observe the output, we'll plot it. That is the output of normal CDF using inbuilt MATLAB functions. So this is it for this video tutorial. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you need further help, you may log into www.matlabhelper.com. Thank you.